starry most a 427-year-old bridge in the city of Mostar, Bosnia, is destroyed, believed to be caused by artillery fire from the Bosnian Coast Forces. 1994, the chemical element, a radioactive synthetic element discovered by scientists in Germany. Oh, that's great. 1989, the largest civil settlement in U.S. history. 37 brokerage houses are ordered to pay $1.3 billion to NASDAQ investors for compensating price fixing. Way to go, dumbass. 2007, Germany passes controversial bill mandating storage of citizens' telecommunication traffic data for 6 months with probable cause. That makes no sense. What the fuck?
Chuck.
I don't know. And once again, there's not really anybody worth really mentioning on birthdays. Nobody that I fucking know. I mean, if there's somebody that's like really famous and shit that we know, I would mention it. But I don't know any of these people. Like, there's names that I've never seen before. So there's your nerd. Nerd on. Get your nerd on. We actually have a good day.
Marine Corps birthday.
Huh?
Tomorrow's the Marine Corps birthday.
What's the Marine Corps?
That's tomorrow. That's not today.
So?
Oh, okay. The crayon guys. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, we'll have to do a little something special for the Marines tomorrow. Like, no shit. Do what?
You can play the Marine Corps hymn as much as it's going to make you want to vomit.
Nah, it's not going to make you vomit. one team, one fight, one love. You know, even though we make fun of each other, Marines, you know, they are a bunch of badasses. Yeah, just like the Army, you know. Even though, you know, Special Forces, Green Berets, whoop ass. You know, it's Navy SEALs. I think it goes to the Green Berets, Special Forces. What special unit do y'all have? Honestly, like, educate me here.
MARSOC?
More socks?
MARSOC!
No, I honestly didn't know. I mean, sue me. I know that looks fucking bad on me for not fucking knowing, but, I mean, I really didn't know. Because I know the Air Force, they actually have a special unit that they can deploy out. And that's you know, where I started to go, but apparently I couldn't run fast enough. Just saying. It's hard to run whenever you're 6'6", carrying around a couple hundred pounds.
You can't catch a chair.
What?
I can catch a chair. maybe not these days, but shit. I still pump out some push-ups. Can't do them in straight form because my leg doesn't lock out and I can't feel my foot, so it's kind of hard to keep that other one straight up in the air. But I do the best that I fucking can. So
that was awesome. I started crying when I watched your video.
Oh
yes.
Well, yeah. You know, I love Dogtag. He does a fucking lot for this community. And he's one hell of a fucking freedom fighter. You know, that was not done for any other intent but to show that man love, plain and simple.
Yeah, I know. That's why it made me cry.
Oh. Well.
In a good way. Like, good and bad. I mean, it freaking sucks. Like, and I'm actually driving through there. I was going to try and stop and see him if I could tomorrow when I drove through. But he's got so many people reaching out to him that I'm kind of like, you know, I let him know. I said, hey, bro, I'm here. Reach out if you need to. But I know what it's like when something happens, because when my brother passed away, like, my phone, like, I could not literally take it off the charger. And, you know, there were people I'd never met reaching out to me and things like that. And it's a really emotional, very hectic, and social media makes it even like 10 times worse. So it's a very hectic time. So what you did was just perfect, because he knows you're there, you love him, and it's not like reaching out to touch him like physically or like bugging him, but it's just letting him know that you're there and you're supporting. So I think it was the perfect way to show love and support, and it touched my heart. So that's all.
Well, thank you, sis, because that was really trying to hold back the tears at the very end of it. Was, you know, I hate to see the man go through that. He's definitely not alone, and he fucking knows that. And, you know, he'll have all the support and love and whatnot from a lot of fucking people, you know. And he actually tagged me in that video this morning, you know, saying thanks and all that stuff. That if he was ever in this fight, he is definitely in this fight even more right now. And I have to go out and say this, since we're talking about this subject. Look, we all know statistically, if you're one of those people that sit there, I'm gonna kill myself, 9 times out of 10, you're not gonna fucking do it. You're looking for attention. It's the people who don't talk about it, or maybe just slightly mention it here or there, or have their own form of, you know, drifting away, and then you just don't know. It's just gonna happen. And those are the people that we need to find a way to reach out to even more. And I'm trying to come up with a plan with a few badass guys, and see if we can't get something done nationwide. Because, I mean, we do Facebook and Twitter, you know, Instagram, you know, all these social media things, you know, it reaches out everywhere, but not everybody sees it because, you know,
not everyone on social media.
That's right. That's right. And if you're not on, even if you are on social media, you still don't quite see it because, yeah, I got 5,000 friends. I can't get no more than that because fucking Facebook is a retard. It won't let me be verified. So we can gain more and more people, so it reaches more and more fucking people. So
yeah,
I'm in the mix trying to scheme up a little plot here and see if we can't do something on a higher scale. And the people that are backing me up on this are bad fucking ass. And I love them. I love every single last one of them. And glad that they're supporting and helping me come up with this, because, you know, they heard about the news and they were calling it check in on me, and I was like, dude, I'm fine, I'm just, you know, just a little distraught, you know, because this is, it keeps fucking happening. Yeah, I mean, even though I didn't know Steph personally, but Daltag's a fucking brother, and we hate to see our family members go through fucking pain, you know.
Yep.
And we want to take it away from them. I'd take away everybody's fucking pain and take it on my damn self, so that way everybody would be fucking happy. But unfortunately, I'm not able to do that. But
I'm the same way.
There's gotta be another way. There's got to be something that we can do that we can put it out there for the whole fucking world to hear. You know, Trump's been a good president so far, but it's time for Trump to open his eyes up to the thousands and thousands of people that we sent over there that are so-called normal, and when they come back, they're
well,
different.
I mean, I have an idea, too. And this would be something, like, for the future, like, maybe next year, when we can all get our schedules for the DGN hosts, can all get their schedules kind of aligned. I think that we should get someone to write a song and do a music video. Like, I have a couple of different ideas in mind. And really try and hit the message even more so than, you know, because there are videos out there and things like that, and they do work and they do help. But I think as a network, if we did something like that, it would show that, you know, as a network, we have no judgment. And, you know, this is something that the whole reason this network came about is because we want to stop. We want to be there and help. And, you know, I think that that message needs to go even further, like you said.
I agree. You write it, and I'll take it to the studio. I'll sing that motherfucker. I know a few other people that would probably put some background drums and guitars and shit into it as well. Because those were a couple of people that did reach out yesterday just to check out. Yeah. And we had a long conversation about this. You know, we got a lot of work to do. And, you know, unfortunately, it's not, as much as we want it to stop, it's not going to. We can't.
Oh, I know that. As much as we want it to, we're never going to be able to eradicate it. But the more lives that we save and the more people that are telling their story and getting it off their chest. And see, that's what a lot of our community does, is we hold it in. And that makes it even worse. The more you talk about what you're going through, the more you let out the pain that's on the inside, the less and less darker everything's going to feel. And I only say that because of my own experiences, and I know what it's done for me as a person. The more I talk about my own experiences, and I see how it changes other people's lives, that gives me more positive light on the inside to keep moving forward. And we've got to stop the trickle effect, because what happens when something like this happens, like what happens when you throw a rock into a lake that's completely still and there's nothing in the way? It's just a ripple that keeps expanding out. Well, what happens when something like this happens? It's like you throw a rock in a completely still lake and there's a stick there. So when the ripple hits the stick, there's going to be a secondary ripple that goes out even further. And then when those ripples collide, there's going to be a third ripple that goes. So it's an ever compounding issue that we're playing catch up in. And we, all of us, especially those who are hurting, you need to make sure you do reach out. And there is no judgment whatsoever from anybody on this station. No one will ever freaking judge you.
God, no.
Nope.
And, I mean, my space is, like, so fucked up right now. I can't even, like, think clearly because of everything that's gone on this week. But I mean, I just hope that I'm getting across the point that I'm trying to get across.
You are. I hear your point loud and clear. And like you say, you know, we all been through our trials and tribulations. You know, I feel like an idiot trying to pull the trigger myself last year. And, you know, I was just in a very, very low spot, didn't have anybody. You know, everybody fucking left. You know, had a best friend for 15 fucking years. Hot one of my fucking prosthetic legs. just for a fucking bag of dope.